might sound stupid, but how many of you know where China is? Where China is? How many of you know where China is? Okay. So we have a lot of Kung Fu Panda fans. Yes, Kung Fu Panda is set in China. Then you also know where India is. It's to the south of China. And the reason why I ask you this is, at this point of time, these are the best reference points to take you to my country, Bhutan, a small mountainous landlocked Himalayan kingdom. A lot of people say that Bhutan is sandwiched between the two giants, but I say that it's placed like a pearl in an oyster because it's unique and rare. We are one of the few countries in the world that has never been captured or colonized. And officially, we are the last Buddhist kingdom. It is said that in Bhutan, we have more statues of Buddhas than we have people living there. The population of Bhutan is only 800,000. And perhaps, if not the only, we are one of the few countries in the world where the traditional costumes are still worn. What you see me wearing, I wear it every day. So we have to wear it every day. When we go to office, when we go to the school, we are required to wear this. It's not just because it's meant, it's required by the law that we wear it, but it's also because we love it. And in 2008, when Barack Obama was elected the 44th president of the United States of America, Bhutan wrote its own history. We completed 100 years of monarchy. And an interesting change happened in 2008. We became the youngest democracy in the world in 2008. And the transition from monarchy to democracy happened in a very unusual way. Democracy was given to us by the monarchy. Bhutanese people were very happy under the monarchy. And in fact, Bhutanese people resisted democracy. They said, we don't want democracy, we are very happy under monarchy. But our king insisted that democracy is the best path for the future of the nation, and thus democracy was imposed to us, and today we are in democracy. We are 10 years into democracy, and our head of state is the king, and the head of the government is the prime minister. We have another historical movement in 2008. Our present king, the king was crowned. We had the ceremonial enthronement of our king, and this also happened in an unprecedented way. He was crowned by his father, the fourth king of Bhutan. And in 2008, we also signed the constitution of our country, and the constitution had a rule for the king which says that once the king attains an age of 65, he will have to abdicate to make way for the crown prince or the princess. But this is not the only rule that we have in the constitution, a different rule that we have in the constitution. The constitution also mandates the country to maintain 60% of its land under forest cover. And you would be surprised to know that presently 72% of our country is under forest cover, and that's why we are the only carbon negative country in the world, which means our country absorbs more carbon dioxide than we emit. Wow. And we have free education. Our government gives free education and healthcare to its citizens. And these are all in line with the development philosophy of a country, which is called gross national happiness, which says that happiness is more important than economic development. So that's why we are sometimes called the happiest place on earth. But when I say this, I don't mean to say that we are perfect. We have our own share of problems, like alcoholism is the leading cause of death in our country. We have rising drug issues. We are fairly new to democracy, so quite a number of our people are apathetic towards democratic involvement. And we are very dependent on imports for basic necessities. cities like food. And we have this growing issue of rural-urban migration, and mental health crisis has also become a serious issue right now. And the government, civil society organizations, non-governmental organizations, and individuals are working to solve this. And I have also joined the cause. And ladies and gentlemen, to introduce myself, my name is Kezang Dorji. I am from Bhutan, and I work as a junior corporate performance analyst there. But I am known more as a musician and as a rapper, to be more specific. I make songs about social issues with social messages. I just don't make songs, but I also talk and work with the civil society organizations for social causes. And I make a song to encourage people to participate in democracy and to vote. I made a song called Dear Prime Minister. And in collaboration with one of the CSOs in our country called Bhutan Center for Media and Democracy in 2014, I also conducted a waste management project in my hometown in Dorji, in eastern Bhutan. And in 2017, with the funding support from International Republican Institute, I did another waste management program in eastern Bhutan in collaboration with a firm called Evergreen Bhutan there. The objective of the project was to introduce the system of segregating waste, which was not in practice there. The project spanned for 3 months. And I also believe that most of the problems in the country are there because of one reason, and the reason is because all the developmental activities are centered in the capital and some of the places in the country. So I create awareness among the youth and people I meet, and I thought that in order to solve this issue, in order to address this issue, equal development of the regions is very important. So I support equal development of regions in the country, so I keep talking about it. And I also feel that in order to make our country economically sustainable, it is very important that we support our local economy. So I go to schools and talk about the importance of buying local products in order to help your farmers, in order to let the local economy grow. And I try to practice what I preach. So I buy mostly local products, and if you come to my place, if you come to my home, that I eat on locally made wooden plates, I drink on locally made bamboo cups, and I'm also I also consider myself as an animal activist. I am a vegetarian, and I've been promoting vegetarianism since my school days. I work in partnership with animal saving civil society organization in my country, and create awareness among the students and the people of the country. And that's why a lot of people see me wearing just my black and plain clothes, because I don't use animal products or insect products. Okay. And the reason why I do this is I believe that more than academics, value education is important. Science is important, innovation is important, but what we need are leaders with good hearts. So that's why I make songs with values, and I try to use my status as a musician to impart value education among my fans, among my listeners. And a lot of people say that we want change. We want change in the society. What I believe is, if we want change, we have to change first. We have to do something different, and when you're doing that, something different in order to bring that change, don't ever underestimate yourself, because you are just one person, because every revolution in the world started with one person. This is the faith which keeps me going. This is the optimism with which I work every day. I have a song in my language, and there's this line which says, So, in English, it means that keep looking at me, I'm going to do a lot of things, I'm just getting started, so keep your eyes on me. So keep looking at me.
dira de na luta dira de ni min keza doji nada chebe sembei kuzu zangpo